The Education Department digging deeper into the alleged maternity leave scam involving teachers. Ara Perez-Sao joins us with that story. Ara, what more can you tell us?
Termina, the DepEd NCR said the committee, it has formed a fact-finding committee that will be led by Chief Administrative Officer Attorney Joylene Dulnuan and will be tasked to conduct internal examination of records and documents to verify the allegations of Ellery Quintia relative to the maternity scam or the alleged maternity scam in DepEd Division of Taguig City and Pateros. Director Wilfredo Cabral also encouraged Quintia, who heads the Curriculum Implementation Division of DepEd Taguig City Pateros, to submit to the said committee his sworn statement, documents, and evidence. DepEd NCR also urged individuals and personnel who may have information on the matter to coordinate with them. The office assured the concerned individuals and the public a fair and impartial investigation. In a text message to ABS-CBN News, Quintia confirmed he is already in touch with his lawyer to work on his statement and affidavit for filing a formal complaint to the DepEd Central Office. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ara Perez. Switching gears now, as Filipinos attend various gatherings this Christmas season, health experts are urging partygoers to make healthy eating choices. More from Michael Deliso.
June used to be a heavy drinker, indulging in drinking sessions at least 5 times a month, some of it stretching from night until morning. He also had a poor diet as he prefers fatty foods. But he has since made lifestyle changes after being diagnosed with hypertension in 2016.
Sobrang hirap ng adjustment kasi syempre hinahanap-hanap ko yung ganun. Pero sa tingin may isip ko na kailangan ko alagaan ng health ko kasi nga syempre naapektuhan yung work ko. Pati siyempre financial magastos pag magkasakit eh. So talagang dinisiplina ako po yung sarili ko.
He now controls what he eats and limits his alcohol consumption during parties. His parents, who are both hypertensive, have also become more health conscious.
Sa inyo, ano yung star ng Noche Buena?
Kasi mahil kami sa pasta. So pero yung pasta namin, ano, seafood pasta na. So para mas healthy siya.
Cardiologists are hoping more people will make healthy choices, noting that the holidays usually see a spike in patients complaining of heart problems.
Yung mga procedure sa mga para sa puso, sa cath lab po ginagawa, mas mahirap mag-schedule. Medyo mas marami po talagang procedures na nangyayari sa Disyembre.
Yung pagkain ng masarap po, kung sunod-sunod, lalo na kapag mataba at puro alcohol, no? Napo, yun, makikita po natin yung pagdagdag ng mga stroke at heart attack. So bilang isang interventionist or tubero, nakikita po, ginigising po kami nun eh. Yun yung pinaka-frequent time na magbukas ng mga ugat.
At least one ER doctor says they record a 50% increase in emergency room admissions due to hypertension and heart attack from December to January compared to other months. Unfortunately, some patients die due to late intervention.
Delay. Nandun po yung kultura ng Pilipino na hanggat kaya mo pang tiisin para lang hindi masira yung selebrasyon ng Kapaskuhan, no? Eh parang, sige, hanggang kaya ko pa, right? Kaya kadalasan po, karamihan po sa mga itinatakbo sa ospital, napansin din namin, madami po yung dumarating sa amin na dead on arrival. Okay, yung ano na, yung nag-cardiac arrest na.
According to the Centers for Disease and Control and Prevention, drinking in moderation means one standard drink or less in a day for women and 2 standard drinks or less in a day for men. Anything more than this raises the risk of high blood pressure.
Yung pong pag-exceed, pag-binge ninyo, sudden spike po yan ng blood pressure, pati yung heart rate. Yun po yung pwedeng trigger sa mga may plaque na, may baral na sa artery ng puso para ma-heart attack.
Beyond this amount, hindi na po kaya ng katawan natin i-metabolize. Ika nga, yung sistema natin, it's no longer enough to deal with the excess alcohol. So nagkakaroon na po ng damage yan.
Indulging is easy with more opportunities to binge out. But at least one chef says the public should rethink the star of Noche Buena beyond the usual ham, crispy pata, or lechon. He also suggests toning down the seasoning by using lemons or calamansi, dried mushrooms, umami, vegetables, and herbs to add flavors.
Mga crispy pata, mga sisig, mga gan. Yun talaga yung nakakondisyon kasi sa utak natin bilang Pilipino, yun ang masarap. Pero if you look at the Mediterranean diet, the Mediterranean diet, di ba it's a very healthy diet? Pero it isn't unhealthy, Pero isn't less flavorful and satisfying?
Chef Tatong says people should practice mindful eating during parties and do away with the tradition of serving enormous amount of foods, which at times end up as food scraps. He says celebrations should be more about spending quality time with people. Michael Delizo, ABS-CBN News.